Hello folks, welcome back to another video. It is Francesco here. Today I wanted to give you a review of 1Password. Now I wanted to give you things like pricing information and how it works. I actually have been using 1Password for a while. My wife actually introduced me to it, which is ironic because I tend to be introducing the apps. But basically, it allows you to store your password securely in one application. And I wanted an overview of the pricing, details that you need to know, and what my experience is of using the application to date. So 1Password actually has a few different pricing plans. The first is a personal and family plan, which is priced at $2 per month. And you can see that it's billed annually. So it's around about the price of Todoist, so the $36 per year, I believe. And you do get a 14-day free trial. And as you can see here, it gives you the 1 personal account with unlimited devices, advanced security with authentication and encryption, alerts on compromised passwords, and it works on all of these devices. Now you can also access the families plan, which gives you up to 5 guests for limited sharing. And as you can imagine, you can share passwords, credit cards, secure notes, and basically manage your family's accounts in one. And that's priced at $4.99 per month, which as you can imagine is billed annually, a little bit more expensive. They do have a business plan, which is, I believe, what I'm on, and it also includes free family accounts and access to their advanced protection, and that's what I also use it for, is be able to sort of have that separation. You can see here it's $7.99 per user, and they do have a Teams pack, which is up to 10 users, and is a flat rate of $19.95. And you can try it out for free. Teams is slightly different because in the 1Password business plan, you get the 5 GB storage, document storage, and 20 guest accessed accounts, as well as much more detail when it comes to the reporting, custom groups, and integrations. There is an enterprise plan, but obviously not probably suitable for most folk. Now, here is my 1Password. I have 3 vaults inside of my account. I really like the watchtower feature where it analyzes what passwords have been compromised on certain websites, and it also gives you a breakdown of any reused passwords or weak passwords, as well as unsecure ones. You can also see which two-step authentication are available, and also any expiring accounts. So it really does keep a good eye on what things are happening in the background that you don't know of, which is quite scary sometimes. Now, I really like the fact that I can use this with Chrome and Safari, and I quickly access this using the sort of Touch ID system, which saves me time. But I'm just going to demonstrate how it works with a login. So let's say I have a login here. I can add the email address, and I can add any other labels or notes or tags down here that might be suitable. And one thing I really like to do is actually use this suggested password thing. So you can copy that and paste it, but you can change how many characters have. If you really want a mental password, then as you can see, it gives you options. But what's really nice is you can actually, you know, make it more memorable. You can make it a PIN code. You can make it a random password, but they actually give you this green line to suggest it's good. Lower green line to suggest it's not as good, and what to include, like minus symbols, minus numbers, and you can regenerate it anytime you want. Now, I really like this because I tend to store most of my sort of notes, private notes and things like that, but you can add a range of different things, including membership, medical records, servers, passwords, credit cards, and bank account numbers and stuff like that. I haven't gone that deep yet, but I have found that the experience has been really helpful for that. You can also add tags, like whether it's been two-step authenticated, choose any secure notes, which can be created through here. And secure notes can basically be anything. You can use Markdown as well, and even still add the labels and tags as well, which is useful for later. Personally, I really like using this sort of as a way to manage, but the one thing I most like about it is, for example, whenever I'm on a page and I need a quick password, then I can quickly get it up alongside it, and I can copy it without actually having to open it up. And every time it reminds me how quality the password is that I can paste into the account. So 1Password has been pretty good so far. I separate things with sort of like the private and shared, and you can create a new vault from here as well. But I find that it's really helpful for me to collaborate with others if I did want. So guys, hopefully that was a nice overview of 1Password. It is available in the link in the description, but it's a really helpful password manager. And I really am impressed with the mobile applications more than the Mac versions, especially because of the Touch ID, especially if you're on Apple devices. Anyway, folks, thank you so much. Hopefully you enjoyed this overview, and hopefully you found this app useful. We'll be right back.